So there are reports coming out that Mueller may file some indictments coming up as soon as in a couple of days. This has people on the left super excited because finally this will prove that Trump and his minions colluded with those dastardly Russians, right? Only the reporting saying that it seems as if the charges are going to be for perjury. There's two people that are basically being named. Both are sort of periphery characters. You have Roger Stone, who's kind of been like an insider in Washington for a long time. And then you have Jerome Corsi, who is someone who worked for Alex Jones' InfoWars, and both of them seem to think that they're likely to be indicted. For what it's worth, Corsi said that his indictment was because he was interviewed by, like, the Mueller's team for 37 hours or so, and he was basically set up in a perjury trap where he was questioned so thoroughly and for so long that eventually they caught him in a small lie, and bam, now they're going to charge him. Now, there is report, from what I've read, a tendency for the FBI and other agencies in DNC, they really like charging people with perjury because if you can't charge them with another crime, it's easy for professional investigators to catch someone up in a small lie. And this lie doesn't have to be about a crime they committed. It could be anything. And then they can elect a charge. Even with the FBI, for example, they don't even have to record you. They just write down what you said in what they call 302s. And for example, Michael Flynn was charged with perjury, who was connected to Trump, right? And his perjury charge, apparently it's reported that the FBI agents that had the investigation of Flynn walked away thinking, okay, there's no way to charge him criminally. Only after Mueller came on did he retroactively then say, nope, we're going to charge him with this perjury, right? So my stance the whole time has been, look, if Trump's people committed any crime, then they should be charged with it. Now, these perjury crimes seem to be subjective, and by no means does it prove Russia collusion. Let's take a step back and look at what the charges so far, because you hear this from people in the Democratic Party. Ah, see, people have already been charged. So there's basically been two kinds of charges that have been levied by Mueller. You have the perjury charges, which Flynn got for supposedly lying about meeting with Russians. You had, but it had nothing to do with collusion. Then you had Papadopoulos was charged because he supposedly lied about his drunken conversation with Alex Downer, who was a Clinton friend, Australian diplomat, who said that Papadopoulos got drunk and said, yeah, some Russian told me about some emails that they might have. But nothing ever came of that. So Papadopoulos like spent 7 days in jail or something to that effect. Those are the type of people that have been charged and what the charges have been. Basically lying to the FBI. Not about colluding with Russians, just about being periphery to stuff that was going on that a Russian person was named, right? Then you have the Russians that were charged by Mueller. These charges were basically, they were charged with being Russian trolls that were spreading disinformation. Apparently, it's okay if you're the mainstream media to spread disinformation, and I mean all of them, right and left, the small right faction that's Fox News and the 95% of the mainstream media that is the Democratic mouthpiece. It's okay for them to spread whatever fake news they want, but don't be from Russia and do it. That's uniquely bad. And you might wonder why, like, if the BBC has a report, or if it takes a side, for example, the BBC clearly was showing report after report favoring Hillary. Why isn't that foreign meddling in our election? Why isn't that a foreign news service? Keep in mind, the BBC gets government, it's part government funded, right, from the UK. So why is it okay for them to do it? Who knows, right? Basically, it's all right when, for, and let's not forget, I'm going off on an aside, but let's not forget that you had people connected to Hillary that were working with the Ukrainian government to help go after people connected in the Trump campaign like Manafort. All of that was okay. None of that was worth a charge, right? But these Russian Facebook trolls, we're supposed to believe that these trolls somehow, you know, the couple, let's say, I don't even know how much money. It was less than a million. So let's even say half a million, being generous. $500,000 in Facebook ads was enough to outweigh the 90% mainstream media coverage, billions of dollars of coverage that was favoring Hillary Clinton, people in the mainstream media giving Hillary Clinton answers to debate questions and things, or debate questions before they were asked and things of that nature. All of that, the billions of dollars put in that. Now, all it takes is a few dozen Russian Facebook trolls to outweigh all that. They're still sticking with that story. And again, isn't it hilarious? They're super concerned about how those Russians, those Facebook trolls, influenced the election. But don't you dare criticize the system in Broward County or anything when we have people that judges have admitted in the past have destroyed ballots illegally running the show in Broward County. But to even question her insane, at least incompetence and most likely corruption, means that you're destroying democracy. you're challenging the system. How arrogant and how hypocritical do these people have to be to spend 2 years complaining that the election was basically stolen by Trump working with Russians and that it wasn't fair, only to now claim that if you dare, it would dare criticize anything that goes on in the election process, that you're destroying our democracy. Little funny aside there, right? So that's the two types of charges we've seen. So, okay, you might be thinking, and I'm sure I have left-wing friends that are possibly watching this, are like, hey, be consistent, Rob, right? You said if Trump's team committed any crimes, they should be held accountable. I'll stand by that. I don't mind people being charged with perjury, even if it was set up as a trap. That's fine. If they broke the law, the law's written the way it is, they should be held accountable. What upsets me is that this law is selectively applied. We see this over and over. Now, keep in mind, my reasoning for voting for Trump in the first place was the same reason that I wanted to see a Trump-Bernie kind of run up, like them to be the two candidates that won their primaries. And the reason was because it was evident to me that the people that I consider establishment, which is the real people with power in the Republican and Democratic parties, who I think basically act as the same party, as you've heard me say over and over, they agree on things like need for foreign intervention into war, Federal Reserve existing and its policies, bailing out big banks, allowing illegal immigration, things of that nature. These establishment Republicans and Democrats all seem to agree. It seemed obvious to me that those establishment Republicans and Democrats didn't want a potential outsider such as Bernie or Trump. That's why they screwed Bernie in the primaries, and they assumed they had it in the bag with Hillary easily defeating Trump, with all the media, all of Hollywood, all of basically the levers of power in our culture being for the Democrats and Hillary Clinton. They were wrong. They lost that. So it's humorous to think, again, that we're going back to blaming these Russian trolls over that huge amount of power that was going for Hillary on that side. So anyways, where it comes in with the perjury, what we end up seeing is that they are going to be indicting, and they already have indicted people like Flynn and Papadopoulos for perjury or lying to investigative agencies. But time and time again, we see people on the establishment side or on the let me go back real quick. I was saying that I feel that the establishment was against Trump and Bernie. Now, it seems like the only people that ever get charged with these crimes like perjury are people that are anti-establishment, right? So that's why we see people connected to Trump are being charged with it, but people that were connected to Hillary that we could prove perjured themselves are actually not indicted for the exact same thing, right? We saw the same thing where Manafort was indicting for their FAR violations, and the FAR was basically failing to register as a foreign agent, right? A foreign lobbyist. So the charge was that Manafort was working for pro-Russian groups in the Ukraine and was basically lobbying United States politicians. He was doing that in conjunction with other groups such as Mercury LLC, which is kind of a lobbying firm that primarily works with Republicans, and the Podesta Group, which was a lobbying firm that worked basically with the Democrats. My name might sound familiar for you because John Podesta, who was the head of who was the campaign chair, Manafort was the campaign chair of Trump's side, right? John Podesta was the campaign chair of Hillary's side. So basically the equivalent of Manafort on Hillary's side, right? His firm that he started along with his brother Tony Podesta is the Podesta Group. That was back in 2012-13 working with Manafort to lobby for Russian interest, right? Manafort was charged. The Podesta Group was gone to by the FBI and said, hey, you didn't register as a foreign lobbyist. Can you kindly retroactively sign these papers so that we don't have to charge you? Isn't that strange how the person connected with Trump does the same thing as the people connected with Hillary, and only the person connected with Trump is charged? Now we're seeing the same thing with perjury, right? All I'm asking is, if you're going to charge people with crimes, then do so equally. The justice should be equal amongst all sides. It is clear time and time and time again that the rules are different for people connected to Hillary and connected to the establishment than they are for people connected to Trump. Over and over, the system goes as harsh as possible against the people connected to Trump and as easily as possible as the people connected to Hillary. So, let me give you specific examples. We have Flynn and Papadopoulos being charged with perjury, right? It appears as if we might see people like Roger Stone and Jerome Corsi charged with the same. So let's look at who perjured themselves close to Hillary. I'll give you three examples, right? The first is a report that I'll link below that shows that Mills and Abedin, Mills, who was Hillary's attorney, and Abedin, who was her direct assistant, two of the larger people in her party, not just periphery characters like Papadopoulos, but two people that were very high up in Hillary's campaign and connected to Hillary, right? Both of them perjured themselves to the FBI. Now, the person that did the investigations of, or I'm sorry, the interviews of Mills and Abedin was a person by the name of Peter Strzok. That name might sound familiar to you. He's the person that was found texting his paramour and lover about how he could smell Trump supporters at Walmart and he needed an insurance policy against Trump. A person who the IG report even said the IG couldn't be convinced that first it said that he had extreme bias for Hillary and against Trump, and he couldn't be convinced, at least in some aspects of his investigation, that that bias didn't influence his actions, right? We know that Strzok was the one who interviewed Mills, Abedin, and Hillary Clinton. Right. So in his interviews of Mills and Abedin, both Mills and Abedin told him, we weren't aware that Hillary had this private server. That's what they testified to an FBI agent, correct? Okay. Then it later turns out that through emails that were actually released that the public can see, both Mills and Abedin are admitting as far back as 2009 that they are fully aware of Hillary's server that she has at home. So they lied. That is proof that they perjured themselves. This is undeniable. We know this. Yet neither of them were charged. We also know that FBI agents claimed that they believed Hillary Clinton lied to them when they were investigating. They think specifically when Hillary said that the C that she saw on top of documents and emails and such, she didn't know that that stood for classified and instead thought that it was just alphabetical order or something of that. The FBI agents, their statements have been released, a couple of them, though I don't know if names have been attached to it, but their texts have been released that said that they thought that that claim strained credibility and that they knew that they would, no one in Hillary's team would ever be indicted for things like that. Now, how does that make sense, right? For all of you people, if you hate Trump and you think it's funny, particularly the third person that there's rumors going that might get indicted for perjury is Don Jr. You wouldn't believe the elation this brings to people on the left. So for all of you that think, oh, perjury is such a huge deal, it's time that these Trump people go down. Where were you when the FBI was letting people connected to Hillary and Hillary herself off for lying to the FBI? For some reason, that perjury was just, well, you know, whatever, those are just little lies, no big deal. But when the people in Trump's campaign lie to the FBI or mislead the FBI, then it's a huge deal. This is the double standard that upsets me and other people, right? It proves that we have an investigative agency, an intel community that is so biased that they'll go after one side as hard as possible and the other side as soft as possible. And what that leads is to a skewed system of justice where establishment people that the intelligence agencies favor are allowed to do whatever they want, lie to the FBI, destroy subpoenaed evidence, have private servers at home, all of that, and they could get away with it because the agents want that side to be viewed in a favorable light and win elections. But if you deign to be someone who's working with a campaign that would criticize the intelligence agencies, then they'll come after you full bore. Now, you might be saying, well, geez, I didn't know this was possible. Maybe the Democrats didn't know that would happen. Oh, I beg to differ. Chuck Schumer told us exactly what would happen 2 years ago when he was being interviewed on a news program, and he said, I don't understand why Trump goes after the intel agencies. They'll find six ways from Sunday to get back at him. Now think about that. One of the leaders of one of the two parties in this country fully admitting you can't criticize the intel agencies or they'll find ways to get you. What kind of system do we have where unelected bureaucrats have to strike fear in the people we elect to positions of power because they will apply their tools to violate the rights of Americans and to arrest Americans selectively? They'll allow some people that broke the law to get off and selectively supply those same laws to go after people that they don't like. That's what is outrageous. Ages, right? I don't care. I've said all along, if Trump broke the law, fine, go after him. If it was a serious law like collusion and he colluded with Russians, then not only should he be impeached, he should be charged with those crimes. That's fine. I don't have a problem with that, right? My fear is greater than just Bill or just Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump and which one of them should have won the election. My fear is that if the intelligence agencies themselves are politicized and weaponized, then we are going to have a far greater problem on our hands than even Russia attempting to influence. The FBI, the CIA, the NSA, groups like that have a far greater ability to influence our elections and our democracy and republic more than any outside country does. And we're seeing yet another example of these powers being applied selectively, if it turns out that these indictments come forth and they're just for perjury. And the last thing I'll say is clearly, I could get blue in the face talking about the hypocrisy of the media and how they're just mouthpieces for the Democratic Party. Remember, they never really reported about all the perjury that was going on with Hillary's side, or the fact she was her side was destroying subpoenaed evidence and things like that. They never really discussed how it was a shame none of them were charged, yet they will go on breathlessly with, oh, how important Mueller is, and how if his investigation has indictments of these people peripherally connected to Trump, then it's such a huge deal. So clearly, we should take everything they say, knowing their extreme bias and they're not journalists, merely cheerleaders for the Democratic Party. But what upsets me is even friends I have and people that I feel are more reasonable, that are left-wing people or Democrats that hate Trump, are elated. They're so pleased, and they can't wait. They're really hoping that these indictments come down on people like Roger Stone and Jerome Corsi for perjury, yet they just will flat out ignore when you're like, what about the perjury on Hillary's side? It's not like they say, no, that wasn't perjury. They just are like, yeah, whatever, that's over and done with, right? If you're willing to sacrifice your, integrity, if you're willing to say, I enjoy the intelligence agencies being weaponized and politicized as long as they're doing it against people I don't like, then you really have no excuse, and you should have no reason to complain when that same intelligence apparatus is weaponized against candidates that you enjoy, right? I'm not particularly a fan of progressive mindset or democratic socialism. I almost said social Marxist, whatever. All the, a horse apiece, I guess. But I'm not a fan of most of those politics. Do you think that any serious progressives ever going to get elected if the intelligence agencies have this power that would deign to go against the intelligence agencies? Of course not. They'll be gone after just like Donald Trump. No outsiders, right? So you really, if you hate Trump, this should be very disturbing to you that these sorts of process crimes will be coming out and they're selectively applied. They weren't applied to people. Don't look at it like, oh, they're being applied to Trump and I hate him, and they weren't applied to Democrats or they weren't applied to Hillary. Look at it like they're being applied to people that were critical, connected to someone critical of the intelligence agencies, and they won't be applied to people that are buddied up with the intelligence agencies, right? Which means that only candidates and only politicians that are tools of the intelligence agencies will be able to proceed and not be weaponized against from these very intelligence agencies. That should scare all of us far more than Russian Facebook trolls, right? Far more than even Vladimir Putin himself trying to interfere in our election. Our domestic intel agencies, which are the strongest in the world, which have the power to unturn everything you've ever done in life, to destroy your privacy, to charge you with any of these process crimes, right? Being weaponized, being kingmakers to decide who they feel fit to serve and go after those they feel aren't. They have the potential to be far more dangerous than any outside group, and that should concern all of us. All right, well, thanks for listening. Please like and subscribe if you like it. Recommend me to some other people. I should be doing a live stream, I think, around Friday at noon, where I'll cover some of the news events of the week, make fun of myself, things of that nature. So please tune in and have a good one.